This is the new CyanogenMod 14.1 custom ROM in Zenfone 2. So it's almost a month using this ROM and I'm finally ready to review this custom ROM. So without any further ado, let's jump to the main sequence. So I have so many stuff here about this ROM after using this for 1 month, and I have to say that I had never used any other custom ROM better than this. Though it's an unofficial build, it's still one of the best and smooth ROM ever. Official CyanogenMod 14.1 will take a little bit of time to come, so you all have to wait for that with me. And if you haven't watched my installation video on this, then go and watch that to see the right tutorial and how you can install that. Link is present in the YouTube show notes. As this ROM is based on Android Nougat 7.1, which is already everyone's favorite. Regarding the performance, no lagginess, it's not lacking anything, it runs like a beast. Handling and opening multiple apps is a lot smoother now, as you can see how quickly it manages and opening the apps, minimizing the apps. There are few bugs present in this ROM, which is a normal thing for a ROM. But also you will get regular updates in 2-3 days, in which few bugs solved and new bugs arrived. You will not able to find any ROM without any bug on this planet. Even the stock ROM of any smartphone has few errors and problems. That's why company gives time to time firmware updates to fix them. Sometimes I got not responding error in few apps like Instagram, Snapchat. But good thing about Nougat is we can mute the repetitive message to get rid out of it. The launcher you will get with this ROM is the old one, which is Trebuchet launcher. But you can install your own favorite one like me. I am using this Google Pixel launcher and had already an installation video on this, so you can install that from my video. Extra benefits with Android 7.1 over 7.0, these in-app options in Pixel launcher, in which you can directly open any submenu of few compatible apps like Chrome, Gmail, Twitter, or you can drag that to home screen for later or regular usage. The notification panel is amazing. I would say it's same as the new Google Pixel smartphone, not the unique feature of CyanogenMod. So every feature like quick tiles in one swipe, in-app reply from notification panel are also available. You can customize the quick tiles according to your own priority. As if you want battery icon every time on top, then you can freely drag this to the top main quick section to see the battery graph or screen on time. I haven't used Google Pixel, so I don't know that this problem is in that phone only or in the CyanogenMod 14.1. And the problem is that when you tap on the Wi-Fi, then it will turn on automatically, and when you tap it again, it will turn off. It will not go in some menu, but this will not happen with the mobile data. When you tap on the mobile data, then you have to further select whether to turn on or not. Maybe if Google Pixel has also this issue, then CyanogenMod developers can tweak this for better UI. I don't believe in benchmarks, but Antutu scored around 66,464, which is great for its specs. I tried several games on this like Asphalt 8, Modern Combat 5, Mortal Kombat X, Leo's Fortune, WWE Mortals, Dead Trigger 2, etc. All are running great without any lagginess or glitch, because RAM works very flawless in this ROM. RAM management is superb. If you check your recent apps, which you leave at night running in the background, then you will find those apps in the same states after few hours or in morning. No app will restart again, so you can continue your work again. RAM management is really good, which was a worst scenario in the stock ROM. And also Auto Start Manager is present in that one, which will not allow the apps to restart again in the background to save the RAM. But that's not work good as it looks. But in this, there is not any app like Auto Start Manager, but still you will get around 1.7 GB of RAM free, and which is a very good thing. Basic apps for daily usage works like a charm, like your social networking apps, Facebook, WhatsApp, or entertainment app, YouTube. But few apps are not compatible with the new OS, like UC Browser, which is used by many users, also me, as it is also not compatible with any smartphone with Android 7.1. So that's not an issue with only CM14.1. So the apps which are not compatible with the Android 7.1 will update their API and optimize it so that we can easily use in Android Nougat 2. And also one of the most frequently asked question, which is the OLT. Everyone is asking about. I already had given the answer on my FB page and Twitter. So if you are not following me there, then you are missing so many updates. In between, the hardware is not compatible for OLT. That's why no OLT for this phone in any ROM, as Asus also stated this thing. Also, you will not get that in future too. I know this is a very sad news for all of you, but that's the truth. Also, a text name sub-1 displays on calling screen while calling to a person, which is not a major issue, which can be fixed by time to time in updates. I'm not facing any issue while calling. Audio, mic and speaker are working fine. Also, no connection lost while calling. And one thing which is not present in this ROM is the FM radio. So if you are a FM radio lover, you don't want to listen music from your internet, you want to surf from the FM radio, then this ROM is not for you, because FM radio app is not available in this, but in future it will be available. So you have to check time to time. Other features like changing few stuffs on status bar, multi windows, quick switching of two apps are also great. So first take a look at status bar icons. You can change your clock position to left, right or center, your small AM, small PM, your big AM, big PM after the time. Also you can change the battery style to circle, portrait or landscape. In beginning, there was a bug in which we can't change the battery style other than the landscape, but that problem has been fixed up now. Second thing is the multi-window, which I want to say really very helpful feature for everyone. People can simultaneously use two apps on one screen. For example, if you are watching a YouTube video but also want to chat with one of your friends or many of your friends in your group WhatsApp, or you want to use Facebook browser, then you can use this feature. So this feature will definitely help you a lot. I personally use this too much while listening or watching songs, videos on YouTube and browsing side by side Facebook. Every app is not supporting this feature like camera. Last thing is the switching between two recent apps. So if you are running few apps in your background and you want to switch in between two apps in few breaks, then double tapping the recent app will help you to do so. This feature was also present in CM13, but this time in CM14 or 14.1, it is more even faster and smoother now. In default stock ROM, you can also use double tap to wake up and wake off feature, which is also present in this ROM. But to wake off feature, you need to tap on the status bar icon, not on the home screen. If you tap on the home screen, it will not work, because Sanity Mode doesn't allow you to do that. So this feature is also available in CM12, 12.1 and 13.2. Just tapping on the status bar will help you in turning off the phone, even if your phone doesn't have any double tap to wake off feature. So this will also allow you to turn off the phone in any condition. The smart gestures like draw C for camera, M for messaging, etc. are also available, like stock ROM. But problem is that you cannot change the default apps like in stock ROM. But for some reason, browser and few other gestures are not working. Maybe they will fix that in future. Next comes the battery life. For screen on time, I want to say one word: awesome. But on the other hand, for standby time, poor. There is a loss of battery percentage in standby state. Every hour there is a 2-3% battery drop down, but if you leave your phone with internet turned on in the background, then you will see a much bigger difference, even more than 3% battery drop down. But during usage, battery does a decent job. I am getting in about 4 to 5 hours of screen on time on a mid usage. Most of the time I use my device while charging, and device doesn't heat a lot. Heating problem is almost fixed in this CM14.1, not like the stock ROM, which was the heat of hell. Now let's come to the camera. Same quality as the previous CM13 or stock ROM. Basic CM camera apps with basic feature in this ROM. To get more features, you can install default Asus camera app, link in the description box. You just need to flash that through the TWRP recovery, and you can also use other apps with the manual option. I personally use Camera FV5 Pro to take better shots, in which I can change ISO, exposure and few other manual controls. You will find this app in Play Store. Many of you want exposed framework. Right now, it's not available for Nougat for any type of phone, but it's in developing stage. But for future, when it will be available, then you just need to install this Expose Framework 3.1 APK and opening it up, and you will able to see here installation zip. Then you will just need to click on that and it will automatically download and install your zip. Still, I will prefer this ROM over other custom ROMs because performance is too smooth. Most of you people are demanding this review video, that's why I made this. So I only want to say, just go for it. You will not able to find any other better custom ROM than this. So this is all about the review of CM14.1 on Zenfone 2. If you enjoy this stuff, make sure to leave a like, and for any type of technical query related to this, just put down your comment in the comment section. Also feel free to share the video. Don't forget to follow me on Twitter, Snapchat and FB page. And if you are new to my channel, then smash the subscribe button for more videos. And I will see you guys in my next video.